Can you see that? Not really.
Okay.
Hey guys, how's it going? In the last couple videos, I've mentioned setting up a stain and finishing room in the basement. I'm just gonna wait for the helicopter. I've since done a little bit of stain work in there and ended up gassing out the entire house. So today, to prevent that in the future, I'm building a window mount fume extractor. I've actually already started this project, but all I've done so far is cut some 2x4 scraps to length and screw them together. So now over at the table saw, I bring out the crosscut sled and set the blade depth to cut out a dado to fit over the window latches. More on that later. With the dados cut out, I build out the frame with screws. Since the 2x4s I'm using are old pallet stringers, they're a little bit warped and beat up. So to take care of some of the warping, I shave off some of the 2x4 with a chisel. Here you can see the window latches I'm working around, but after a test fit, it seems like the frame is still a little bit too big for the window. Since I've already screwed the side sections together, I don't want to risk running the frame through the table saw to trim off the sides. So I break out the belt sander with a 60 grit belt and shave down the sides and screws as needed. Once the belt self-destructed, I figured now was a good time for another test fit and it was good to go. My basement windows are the old style aluminum frame windows, so they were fairly easy to pop out for the fume extractor to go in their place. I actually had to repair one of them that had shattered a while back, and if you missed that video, you can check it out up here. So now that the frame is built and fit to the window frame, I'm changing directions and starting on my prototype for the mounting system for the fume extractor, since this is planned as a temporary removable unit. Over at the table saw, I cut some 2x4 scraps to square and cut a dado through the middle of the block and set it off to the side. And now for the more prototype-y part of this section, sacrificing one of my 12-inch F-style clamps, I break out the angle grinder and grind out the rivet holding the fixed arm in place, and then knock the rivet out with a punch. Well, I call it a punch, it's really a landscape spike that I ground to shape on the belt sander. With the foot removed from the clamp, I bring the block back, pre-drill through the rivet hole, drop the clamp through the dado, and screw in all of the way through. And then with the prototype done, it looks like it should work. I make 3 more, but I won't subject you to watching all 4. So the direction of the wood grain was definitely a factor here.
It seems like neither one is all that good. I already have a crack starting there, and I've broke probably more of the end grain ones than the side grain ones trying to do this. Well, actually no, it's about 50-50. But yeah, let's see if these work.
Moving back to the rest of the fume extractor, I started building out the outside with pressure-treated plywood. Unfortunately, I didn't have as much scrap as I thought left over from my shed door. If you missed that video, you can check it out up here. My way around this was to rip down some strips of plywood at the table saw and frame around the outside of the frame with a 2-inch lip around the outside of the 2x4 frame. This was cut down later since I screwed up in my measurement and it ended up being a little bit too big for the window. Then I used my remaining larger scrap sheet to close in the center of the frame. With the frame closed in, I start figuring out the vent. To install the vent, I break out the hole saw kit and cut out the hole. Unfortunately, I didn't realize where I had drilled the hole, so to give me enough space to insert the vent, I mark out the vent, drill out the corners with the Forstner bit, and started to knock out the rest with a chisel, but shortly swapped over to the jigsaw. Then I screwed the vent in place. With the vent installed, I flipped the unit over to install the vent hose, and tape it into place with some foil tape. Since this is going to be installed in a window, I'm going to be insulating the cavity, so I pull some insulation out of storage in the rafters, cut it to size, and install it in place. Then before I can close in the interior side, I need to drill out another hole with the hole saw. But my batteries were running a little bit too low to run the hole saw. Apparently I figured it was better to completely strip out my hole saw with my big drill on hammer mode, since I forgot to switch it off, and then cut out the hole with a jigsaw. With the hole cut, I can close in the fume extractor. To run the fume extractor, I ran over to my local ReStore and picked up an old bathroom fan for about 20 bucks. I pulled the motor out of the housing to connect the hose to the housing with some more foil tape, screwed the housing into the plywood, and then I reinstalled the motor. To wire up the motor, I cut off the original plug for the motor, connected one line to a light switch, and to bring power to the unit, I picked up a replacement appliance cable and connected that to the switch and remaining line from the motor, and I was happy to see that with my test, everything spun the right way, so I was good to go. Then it's time to install my clamp mounts in each corner, and at this point the unit is pretty much finished. The next day I popped the windows out of their frame and put the unit into place. Then from inside I noticed that my clamp mounts don't work quite as well as I intended, and they just tilt away from the wall as I tighten them into place. My quick way around this was to put a scrap piece of wood between the two opposing arms to hold them into place, and that put the necessary opposing force against the clamps to hold in the unit. It's not the best solution, I'm sure, but it's what I came up with in the 30 seconds or so of thought I put into it. I guess a little bit more prototyping couldn't have hurt. Then off camera, since I could feel a fairly decent draft coming past the unit, I sealed up the perimeter and any joins in the plywood with some caulking. And at this point, the project is pretty much done, and I am happy to say it works very well. Though, one might say it works a little too well. With the cold months plaguing us currently, we have all of our windows closed to keep in the heat. I was typically keeping the fan running for a day or so after any finishing work to vent the room. This apparently caused an air imbalance in the house and ended up pulling fumes and carbon monoxide back down the chimney and caused us to evacuate the house twice before we finally figured out what was causing it. Now if I need to use the fume extractor, I make sure I have another window open in the basement to make sure that there isn't anything being pulled back into the house other than fresh air. Other than that, I'm fairly happy with how it worked out, and it's gotten a fair bit of use this winter so far. Now I can stain in the basement without having to smell it in the rest of the house for the next week. Carbon monoxide and all. And with that, I'm going to call it a video. So, thank you guys for watching, and if you like what I'm doing here, give this video a thumbs up and subscribe for more. If you have any questions or comments, I look forward to reading them in the comment section below. And if you want to see more current projects, you can follow me on Instagram at JohnTheSchreiner. Otherwise, I hope to see you in the next video, and have a good one.